despite a rocky start this afternoon. The Quinnipiac women's basketball team went into the locker room trailing by three, but a 5-0 quick spurt by the Bobcats, and they never looked back. A 69-53 victory here in New Rochelle, New York, Sunday afternoon against Iona College to win its second straight Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference Championship. Welcome inside the Rebound, presented by Q30 Television and Q30 Sports, alongside of Tom Albanese. I'm Ari Hirsch-Gordon. Tom, what a day for Trisha Fabry and her Quinnipiac women's basketball program.
She's obviously very happy at this moment, Maury, because earlier in the year, we came into the season knowing that this team was much younger than last season's team, with only two seniors really leading the charge for this team. And we were always concerned of how would they respond when they were 0-3 earlier in the season. Well, they responded with 17 straight wins to end the regular season with their second MAC championship, as you talked about, Maury, in regular season play.
Fabry was asked in the post-game press conference, was she surprised to see 17 straight wins? And she said no, because the day-to-day improvement, the week-to-week improvement, the month-to-month improvement is there for the Quinnipiac Bobcats. Is that what you saw today, catapulted in the regular season championship game?
Absolutely. And what you're talking about with this team is how one thing Trisha Fabry always does, and she's told this to myself and numerous people every single week, they always looked forward to the next game on their schedule. And one thing that this team has been able to do was how they've been able to readjust their offensive game plan for game per game as the game went on. And what's really interesting is how they've just been able to do it with so much potential from these younger players stepping up to playing almost as if they're juniors and seniors when they're really only freshmen. You have Paula Stromani continuing to improve, scoring all of her points in the second half, leading to another double-double for her, and Aaron McClure continuing to produce as well with 7 points tonight. And just this team overall has been able to step it up every game since their early season, the losing streak rather, earlier in the season, and it just hasn't stopped for them. They're much more comfortable in the offense that Trisha Fabry has created for them, and it's on their way to the MAC tournament where they're hoping to create exactly what happened last season with all the upperclassmen seniors they had.
The season ends, and the day ends, I should say, in Quinnipiac's favor, but the day started with Iona. It was senior day, yes, and it honored one of the most accomplished, one of the most polished players in the league's history in Joy Adams. 1,538 rebounds going into the game, ranking 9th currently before the game in NCAA Division I basketball history, but she was limited today. What about the defense of Quinnipiac held her to minimal production?
Well, what Joy Adams really likes to do is really go inside with her passes and on occasion even dribble inside the paint to try to get those quick layups, jump shots within the paint, etc. She's been able to do that nonstop throughout most of the other MAC opponents that Iona's had to play. She's been able to do well is not only defend the perimeter, but defend the paint as well. You have players like Paula Strobmani when she's on the court, Morgan Mance when she's on the court, two big bodies like that to really prevent Joy Adams from really going inside to what she's accustomed to doing, what her comfort zone is. And it's just that Quinnipiac's defense has continued to improve over the stretch of this 17-game winning streak that they're on now. And there's just no stop in sight. They have been able to take out whatever their opponent is, whatever their best player is statistically. They've been able to take them that person out with strong defense. And again, it continued tonight, in this case with Iona and Joy Adams.
Adams, only 11 points, 6 rebounds. Tom, you know, you've seen her for 4 straight years, night in and night out. You can expect double-digit points, double-digit rebounds. You know, you could even throw a 7 in there for an assist or a 7 in there for steals. She's just that dominant of a player. But let's get down to the details of the game. Quinnipiac trailed 14-8 after a slow first quarter. It once trailed 13-2 and finished on a 6-1 run to go into the second frame. But then Quinnipiac really started to pick it up. Who, in your eyes, was the difference in the second quarter?
The second quarter and early on, and getting into the early parts of the second half, Paula Stromani really started to really click beginning in the third quarter. And when Quinnipiac really started to get back on their feet, come out of the timeout that they had at the end of the first quarter, it really settled down. As you mentioned, they started out really slow, but Carly Fabry Aaron McClure, Paula Stromati, and even Morgan Mance from time to time, and most importantly, Maria Napolitano continuing to produce offensively. She started, we both really saw her start to click from behind the three-point arc in the second quarter, continuing to do what she does best, not only producing inside plays for her teammates, but shooting behind the arc, something that she does absolutely best in key games like this one. And just the momentum from each of these players continuing into the second half and leading to Quinnipiac's victory and another regular season MAC championship.
You mentioned a lot of players there. Paul Strautmanet, despite being in foul trouble in the first half, was limited to minutes, but 11 points in the third quarter for the freshman. The Latvian product will be an absolute force. She has Joy Adams type potential. Let's just throw that out there, Tom.
Absolutely.
Joy Adams type potential for Paula Strautmanet. And then you talk about the senior, Maria Napolitano. There are no words to describe her effort tonight. 16 points. She locks down a couple great Iona players on the perimeter, Lizarazu, Robinson. It didn't matter who she guarded. She, in my opinion, is the MAC Defensive Player of the Year. And then Trisha Fabry is the MAC Coach of the Year. Second half, though, Quinnipiac makes a run, goes up by 20, and then, you know, just the smiles and the joy on their faces on the bench, you could tell that they really wanted this one.
They most certainly did, Maury. And what's really interesting, you talk about Maria Napolitano, is how she's been kind of had to adjust in her senior year to a role that she had last season, starting five all last season, all seniors. What does she end up doing? She ends up winning MAC's Sixth Player of the Year award in her junior year. She comes into this year as one of the seniors, one of the four captains on the team, really increasing her role as a leader, and she's just producing offensively in accordance to what she did last season as that sixth supporting player to those other starting five, as we've talked about millions of times before. This Maria Napolitano just continues to produce offensively, and as you mentioned, she is definitely deserving of MAC Defensive Player of the Year because of how much potential she has, and she just continues to really neglect, and like anything that she's had in terms of issues in her past with playing defensively, she continues to improve and just continues to shut down that opposing strong player, as I talked about earlier. And Maria Napolitano definitely one of the main reasons why Quinnipiac is where they are right now. 17 straight wins, second straight MAC regular season title. They would not be here without their leader, Maria Napolitano, Maury.
A 5-7 record, an 0-3 record in conference play early January. The team turns it around. It's now won 17 straight. It's 22-7 overall, 17-3 it finishes the MAC regular season, Tom. Quite the turnaround for the Bobcats, I should say. Like you mentioned, six seniors, gone, five starters gone out of the lineup, but it doesn't matter. Trisha Fabry welcomes a challenge, and boy, did she excel. Let's look into the MAC tournament just to drop. It starts on Thursday afternoon. Quinnipiac will play Friday at noon against the winner of the 8-9 seed, so that winner is to be determined. But what does Quinnipiac, as great as they've been, still need to work on just to shore up some tight ends going into the tournament?
I think the most important thing, and we saw this this afternoon against Iona and a couple other games earlier in the season, but they continue to improve it as the season went on during their winning streak, Maury. It's getting out of the gate to a strong start. This team has had some negligence, so to speak, in terms of getting a little bit slow out of the gate. But one thing that they have been able to produce on is defensively. Their defense has been strong as ever over the last month or so. And this team continues to improve that way. Really, you really can't see too many weaknesses with this team. Paula Stromani has been producing on a daily game-to-game basis. Aaron McClure has done it as well. Maria Napolitano, Carly Fabry, Adelie Martucci, list goes on. Every single one of these players plays a huge role. But if this team can get out of the gate to a little bit of a much better so to speak, than what they've shown in a couple of the games, including this afternoon's game against Iona, this team doesn't look beatable in this MAC tournament, Maury. This is going to be a really great team. And if Quinnipiac can do what they did against Iona this afternoon, again, potentially, should they meet up in the MAC tournament, I don't see any MAC opponent beating Quinnipiac. Yes, we've talked about it with other sports. It is tough to sweep a team in the regular season and into the playoffs. But this Quinnipiac team just looks solid on all cylinders. The only thing, like I said, if they can get off to the quicker starts, they're going to be just fine in the upcoming MAC tournament, Maury.
Well, you heard it here first. Tom Albany says Quinnipiac, if it shores up a couple things, is almost unbeatable come the MAC tournament. They are looking to win three in Albany, go back to the NCAA tournament. That would mean a second consecutive 20 straight game-winning streak in conference. Tom, thank you for all of your analysis, and thanks for coming down this afternoon with me.
Maury, it's always a pleasure. I love to do stuff with you, and thanks so much for inviting me and having me be here today.
Once again, Quinnipiac 69, Iona 53. Quinnipiac, back-to-back Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference regular season champions. For all of our producer staffs in Hamden, Tom Albanese, I'm Maury Hirsch-Gordon. We'll see you next time.